'Twas the night before Christmas, when all over the house not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The milk crates were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. Little Neil was all nestled in his tortoise-shaped bed, while visions of rock collecting danced in his head. Neil's mom in her nightie and I in my DJ hat had just settled our munchies for a long winter's nap, when on the lawn there arose a big clatter. I jumped out of my bed to see what was the matter. Over to the window I ran like a flash, opened the shutters, and hid my stash. The streetlights on the sidewalk made all the garbage show, when what to my whacked out eye should appear but a friggin' red sled and 8 magic reindeer. Where did this wiry driver come from? I knew then and there it might be Neil Young. Faster than Camaros, his magic horses they came, and he whistled and hollered and called them by name.
Now Masher, now Rancer, now Branson, now Lixon, on Crumpet, on Stupid, on Bonner, on Vixen, to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all.
So up to the housetop Neil's magic horses they flew, with a sleigh full of toys and Neil Young too. When in a twinkling I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof, I drew in my head and was like turning around. Down the chimney Neil Young came, pound by pound. He was dressed in Brooks Brothers from head to his foot, and his clothes they was covered with ashes and soot. A bundle of rocks was flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening up his pack. His eyes how they twinkled, his dimples how merry, his cheeks were red as his nose, probably from drinking sherry. His funny little mouth was like an emocon, and the beard on his chin was as lame as that of a fawn. An electronic vape he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his head like a reef. He had a broad face with the build of a nerd. This guy is Santa? Now that's absurd. He slid me at 20, and I did pretend without rest to make him my friend, though not my best. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work, and filled all the milk crates, and then turned like a jerk. And laying his finger just up his nose, giving a nod, sup, sup, up the chimney he rose. With speed and passion on the sleigh he did jump, as for a certain 80s TV star we'd both like to hump. And I heard him exclaim as he flew out of sight,
"Happy Christmas to all, and to all, a good night!"
Hello, my name is Andrew Chalmers, and I am the creator, star, head honcho, grand poobah, I'm not really, of Doctor Who Dark Journey.
You're laying it on kind of thick there, like we all know. Well, hey everybody, it's Johnny Rock, hey, how's it going?
I mean,
I'm a fan of Doctor Who Dark Journey, but you're laying it a little bit thick.
Well, I don't really get the credit that I think I deserve, so it's Christmas. And my Christmas present to myself is to be an egocentric maniac.
Happy Christmas to you, then.
Okay. Well, thank you very much. I'm not really.
No, you're a nice guy. You're so nice. Everybody says he's so nice. That's what everybody says. You're so nice. Like, when you meet him, you'll be surprised how nice he is. And I'm like, I don't know. I already think he's pretty nice. And then I met you. I'm like, he's a nice guy.
Yeah, you were drowning in niceness.
No, you.
Yeah, that's,
oh, you mean they say
yeah,
about you?
Weird, yeah. I've been described as a warm peach, because I'm very fuzzy.
I'll bite.
And I'm a little bit fruity. Mm-hmm. And I also rot very quickly. So okay. That's bad.
This is all getting a bit fuzzy. Let's do the Christmas. Let's do the Christmas thing.
Okay.
Like a peach, you get it?
Like a peach. Yeah. Right, should I do it again?
No, just do it, okay. Christmas. Say Merry Christmas, and then,
Merry Christmas.
It's part of the song, so.
Today, I will be the maestro for this song.
Hit it.
I'm going to do the scales, like a fish.
Yeah, nice.
You know what? It comes back to you. It's like riding a bike.
Or swimming upstream.
Yeah. Oh, right. Oh, as that sounded, like riding a bike into a wall.
On the 12th days of Droidmas, our truth gave to us
12 or of Lakeport,
11 awkward Katies,
10 baby pigs,
9 fits of rage,
8 pots of coffee,
7 sharks with lasers.
6 walkers walking.
5 what the fucks.
4 well shits.
3 hellos.
2 parental warnings.
And one night stand with Neil's mom.
Happy Droidsmas to all from
Johnny Rock
and Andrew Chalmers from Doctor Who Dark Journey.
I'm not from Doctor Who Dark Journey, but I'm from a different
You're
thing
from
drinking
a,
in the like park. A, but I want to be part of the droid.
You're more than welcome.
Yeah.
Just don't bring that guy with you. The other guy.
Neil Young.
Dr. Steve from Chatting with Dr. Steve.
Gabby Poole.
The Mountain Man.
The Con Stranger, DanMo.
The new Katie.
This is Chris Harrelson.
And myself, Todd. We wish you a
happy holidays and enjoy your chimichangas. Something Deadpoolish.
Hey gang, Ralph Garman here.
This is Inspector Gadget.
Hello, this is Andrew Chalmers, the writer and doctor in Doctor Who Dark Journey.
Hello, this is Dr. Steve.
Hey, what's cracking, y'all? It's your boy J-Rock.
This is James Duval.
Hey, what's the sitch? This is Kim Possible.
This is Jeremy Taggart.
I'm Chris Holden Reed.
I'm Commander Shepard.
Hey, I'm DJ Jenny Rock.
And I'm Neil Young.
Hey, this is Andrew Cassess.
Hey, this is Pat Mastriani from Degrassi, Joey Jeremiah.
This is the evil Dr. Bad Vibes.
Then this is Messy Bear. And this is more from X-Men.
Hi, this is Robert Carradine.
This is Sean Gunn.
Hey, it's Zach Callison.
Hey, everyone, it's Tammy Stronach from The Neverending Story.
Everybody, this is the Governator. Listen, I'm telling you this, okay? So listen to me carefully. You're listening to Droids Canada. Can you believe that? I can't believe you're listening to it. Come with me if you want to live.
Warning. Listener discretion is advised.
That means there's a lot of fucking swearing.
Hello.
Why don't you play something Christmassy?
Like what?
This is Christmas music. Come on, diehard.
Hello?
It's not Christmas until Hans Gruber falls off a Nakatomi Plaza.
100%, dude. No truer words have been spoken.
Oh my god, that's hilarious.
I share that post every Christmas.
It is a Christmas movie.
It is.
100%. 100%.
You know, this is the 6th Christmas that we just recorded so many episodes, and we're recording one more even after this because we want holidays.
That's right, man. When this is being aired, I'll be already.
Will you be in Disney?
Probably.
You're gonna be in Disney on Christmas Day.
No, not Disney Christmas Day.
Are you actually gonna post this Christmas Day?
I'll tell you.
No, it'll be like Christmas Eve.
It's a Tuesday, isn't it?
I think Christmas is a Tuesday.
When the calendar fills up. Yep, Christmas Eve.
So this is, you're listening to this on Christmas Eve, Monday the 24th.
I've already been home from my Disney trip, and man, I had a great fucking time.
That's impressive.
I mean, how was Disney this time? Did you have another run-in with Kylo Ren?
Well, no, Disney this time, you have to understand that they do, they deck out Disney in Christmas, and they have something called the...
No shit.
Like a Christmas party kind of thing.
Which, hey,
in Florida, they make it fucking snow.
Did you know they celebrate Christmas in Florida, AJ?
They do?
I mean,
I'm shocked.
Listen, they make it snow on Main Street in fucking Disney.
Did you know in Dexter, Florida, they celebrated Christmas in Dexter?
Well, it's not snow.
It's snow.
Like fake lake shit.
Yeah, but still, like...
You know, people like ask me all the time, Todd, how come you don't come to conventions in December? Like, I don't know. Dan's not home. So what is it, Dan? What makes you go to Disney so much?
Because he doesn't want it to be fucking cold.
Well, it's a good argument.
It is enjoyable to go where it is a little bit warmer when you are cold. But it is
an Italian thing? You gotta stay warm?
It's a wonderful
thing. You can't water the driveway in
Because
Disney.
Like almost every Italian movie, they're like, Uncle Drew need to go down to Florida.
Because they always got droughts and shit.
Yeah, you gotta...
No,
gotta
it's...
Is it because you gotta go back down to the tomato farm? I don't get it.
Keep the tomatoes watered. Gotta make a sass.
And the plum trees.
Make a nice sass.
Gotta make a nice fucking gravy.
You know, we still have to make that episode of us cooking while getting drunk. On a podcast.
Drinking and cooking.
I can see that being bad. We'll have like a crock pot in here.
Welcome to cost-efficient cooking for your modern-day drunkies.
Yeah. We'll teach people how to cook it on like the freaking engine block.
This sauce is not thick enough. Add more Patron.
So this is the Droids Canada Christmas extravaganza.
Extravaganza.
Merry fucking Christmas to all of you. Now, if I can bring up something. If I can bring up something. So I have a very Christmassy family.
Hopefully it's not food.
And this is for me. Yous will find absolutely no entertainment with this.
Oh, okay.
Can you please type up Trans-Siberian Orchestra Christmas Canon? Can you please do that for me?
Good. I know it.
Can you please do that?
I listen to TSO all the time during Christmas.
So
I always wanted to go see them.
Now.
They usually Hamilton like almost every year.
So this is being shown on
Some Afro Man?
The Christmas Eve.
Yeah.
So 2 weeks ago, approximately, they had a wonderful show in Buffalo, like the 14th of December.
Shit, I just saw it.
So
Christmas Canon
Christmas,
Rock?
No, Christmas Canon.
I just literally saw it a second ago. It's Christmas Canon Rock.
Yeah, whatever, same shit. Okay. Click it.
Click, click, click.
Click, clickity.
Is it music or is
yes,
it just?
Yes, it is.
Hold on, I gotta do a nice fade.
Okay, fade. Good job.
Hey man, it's all being professional.
That was
I'm
nice
not like
fade.
Some people that's like today's podcast.
Okay, no.
iTunes reviews.
Second one. There you go.
That'll share my throat a little bit.
You're killing the iTunes reviews, man.
Oh, fuck iTunes.
So
they can just write bad reviews on fucking SoundCloud for all
iTunes.
I care. AJ lost his
AJ lost his Christmas mic.
Oh, God.
That's right.
AJ.
This is it.
What are you doing to us? I can't meet. Hold on. Go. Ah, we still heard it anyway.
This is the greatest Christmas song.
I can't hear you're talking. Like, I mean, if you want me to listen to it, you gotta stop talking.
It's the wedding song being done on Christmas.
This is the wedding song?
Canon in D. Yes.
It is. However,
I will return.
Are you gonna have another? Okay, can we pause this? Listen to you
pause
pee.
It.
Are you
pause
pee?
It.
Are you taking a dump?
Where's he going?
He's going to take a pee. Hold on. I don't know what he's doing. He's in the bathroom.
If he was taking a pee,
no,
we
back.
Would hear.
Oh, he went to go.
If he was taking a pee, we'd hear because you have the bassiest toilet ever. It sounds like deep pee.
I would like to point out that I was kind of envious of your pee stream earlier. It was very manly.
So when it gets more into it a little bit, it's Trans-Siberian Orchestra. This is the Christmas Canon.
Now, what does this have to do with our website?
I have an ongoing thing with this song. Because...
Why is it raining glitter?
It's one of those things, once you see
it's
it...
snow.
That's not snow, that's fucking... Fucking wrapping
it's
paper cut up
snow.
In small little squares.
It's stage snow.
Stage snow is like snow. That is not snow. That's called making a mess. Litter.
It's for effect. Look at it. That's kids. It's a choir. They're singing.
Snow is not reflective.
And do you know what they're singing about?
I don't know.
They're singing about
a wedding.
No. They're singing about a Christmas snack.
The Christmas Canon Rock?
Rum balls?
No. This is a
like
Christmas
a crack
snack. Because if you listen
Albert
to
Street.
The lyrics, if you listen to the lyrics, Merry Christmas snack.
So when
but listen to it, snack.
That's just what you're
so
hearing.
So like Pogos.
I was thinking, well, for Welland, it'd be a crack rock.
I was going to say, do you think meth heads celebrate with crack rocks?
What would be the Welland Christmas snack?
It would be a rum ball, but it's not rum, it's OV.
But no, Welland, well, it's OV balls. So, no, but
I thought you'd like that.
Is a time to, you know, have something really special. So, what would it be, like Sev nachos?
No. That's not Wellandy.
That's not Wellandy.
That's just 7-Eleven. Yeah. I mean, that's
well and fine dining, dude.
No, well and fine dining would have been like what was that?
No, it's a McDonald's drive thru because they have a waterfall.
I never understood that. That didn't make no sense to me at all.
It's well and fine dining for you.
No. Well and fine dining would probably be a large double double. And
fucking give her
a couple shots of Bailey's.
Yeah, that really spice it up. They're gonna go like, can I get that extra chocolate shot in my coffee? Ooh, easy. Pump the brakes there.
Would it be coffee one hand, Robitussin?
No, it'd just be like a large double double, a Toonie Tuesday combo, and res darts.
I love Toonie Tuesday.
It doesn't really exist
apparently
anymore.
Apparently, was it today? They had like Toonie KFC poutine.
They did?
I think so.
Black Friday poutine?
Yeah, I think so.
I would not.
So
eat
that wasn't today because this is
I would not
Christmas
eat that
Eve
shit at all.
Well, it's not Christmas Eve, but it is.
It is Christmas Eve.
No, it's not.
It's the magic of editing.
It's the magic of editing.
That's right.
Hang a shining star.
So on Christmas we celebrate many things.
Okay. There's another song maybe you should play too. It's kind of funny.
Which one is that?
Walking around in women's underwear.
No.
Is that a Winter Wonderland?
Oh. Oh.
No, I'm going to put on the song that's sent to me every single year from my brother from a different mother, Pete Sutter.
That even the name rhymed with Mutter from a Different Mutter.
Yeah. Butter. They're going to be reunited very soon. Uh-huh. They will already have been reunited by the time this airs.
They've already been reunited. How is it reuniting?
It was fantastic.
It's fucking great. It's like Disney, man.
It's like
fucking
Disney.
God, yes! Great.
Where is it?
That looks like Satan's Solution, dude.
No, that's not it. Where is it?
That's
there it is.
Evil.
I think this is it. Or is it a video game?
That's an ad.
No, it's not it. Damn
it. Ads.
It's the name of the song.
I don't know. I keep wondering how after all these years, he still doesn't have a fucking ad blocker.
I do it on purpose because I know it bothers you.
Do you?
It's not there.
Oh, I heard the other one earlier. Don't worry. He didn't. I did.
I've given like 4 or 5 of them this episode. So, Merry Christmas.
Hey, if we ever have a contest with him, we should do that. Count how many gun clicks there are.
How many gun clicks?
Yeah.
There it is.
That'd be the
found
new
it.
Comp test.
New comp test? Dude, I'm always up for a new comp test.
Sent to me every single year.
Why?
It's Carcass. The song's called Secret Satan.
Why do they always look so serious?
Because they're not, you know, they're not hardcore until they're lost out in Finland woods.
What's with the?
No, wasn't that like the Black Satans or something?
That was the Black Satans.
Yeah.
Who's
this from?
This makes the Black Satans look like fucking Metallica.
Dan's face says it all.
Why is there a scantily clad girl dancing? Because that is metal.
This is black metal.
This isn't a black metal.
Don't ruin it. Satan was holding a drum kit in his hand.
With 3 bass drums. You only have 2 feet. Maybe why do you need 3 bass drums?
Maybe one's tuned differently.
Fuck you, drummer.
Hold on, wait.
Ever.
I keep playing it because his face gets funnier. Isn't that the worst though? When you do like a Secret Santa and they don't give you the receipt. And you're like, it's the most stupidest thing ever.
It's not about that, though. It's not about the actual thing you get.
No, sometimes it is. Dan, sometimes it is. Okay? Let's be
honest. I'm involved in a Secret Santa right now that we just wrapped up probably like a week ago.
What am I looking at?
Because this is Christmas Eve.
Okay.
So, yeah, and ours went off without a hitch.
Okay, well.
A merry little Christmas.
The one year I had people over for Christmas, I had Christmas dinner here, and I loaded the YouTube video of Darth Vader roasting on an open fire.
Oh, I remember the one time.
It was like 10 hours with Christmas music.
Quite a number of years ago, we ended up going over to Elsa's place, and they had like the...
Who, Bob?
Yeah, Bob. And they had the fireplace thing on from like Kojiko.
Yep.
And it was just nonstop. And all you saw every once in a while was
the poker guy poking it.
Yeah. Yeah. His name's Olaf.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Olaf
came back, stoking the fire.
We literally have that on our house all the time.
Yeah. Your brother was there. He ended up going. Us, Chyna, and this is at his old place.
Yeah.
Before he moved to Oakland or whatever.
You always have that. There's always someone always has to poke up.
You got
to point out that the guy with the poker. Hey, there he is.
There's Olaf.
Like the poker. Yeah. Shit, I missed him again.
You know what's funny? Things that we hated as kids as gifts is now the things we look forward to as adults.
What, like gift cards?
Gift cards and socks.
Yeah, socks are awesome.
And Gitch.
I just
I'm okay with that.
I just happened to get the greatest socks gift whatsoever.
What?
The Game of Thrones 12 Days of Socks.
Fucking nerd.
It's a big, thin box where each day you pull out your different pair of Game of Thrones socks.
So it's like an advent calendar of Game of Thrones socks.
Yes, and it's called the 12 Days of Socks, and you get 12 pairs of socks.
But are there 12 houses?
I'm afraid I'm kind of...
What's that? Are there 12 houses?
Well,
There is no 12 houses.
I'm going to say yes, because I have opened all these, seeing how this is Christmas Eve. I haven't opened them yet.
Why?
Way before Christmas Eve.
We can still hear you.
You
know you're the fuck!
Jen, if you're listening, don't listen to that last 13 seconds.
Okay, you tell her now.
Yeah, at that point, you know.
By the way, he knows what socks he's getting. He's already looked.
I bought them myself.
But she won't know.
Black Friday.
She won't know because she won't be hearing this until Christmas Eve, so it's okay.
Yeah, she doesn't even listen to the show, right?
No. Christmas, honey. Every now and then she listens.
Oh, no, she does. Oh, she does the spot check. Oh,
she does. She does the spot checks, and I usually get questioned. Like, legit questions.
Okay, now, you know what? This sparks an interesting conversation, AJ. What question? What was the most recent one?
I don't divulge. I'm sorry. I do not divulge anything about the Jen during the show. I don't, and I won't. That's my line.
He's going to tell us off air.
No, he won't. He's telling us off air, Jen.
Why are you swearing?
As you know, I am very secret, not secretive about the Jen, but
you're private.
Exactly.
Make it sound like she's tied up somewhere.
Compartmentalized.
Oh, fuck. Oh, you don't know that.
That's a big fucking word. I just pulled that out of my ass.
Wow.
Yeah.
Cool. That's a big word for you.
That gives me an idea for a show in the news.
So what is pulling it out of your ass?
What? Nope.
That's the name of the porno.
No. No, in the beginning of the year.
You know, every time it's funny that we say pulling things out of your ass. So when I'm downloading freaking torrents for TV shows, sometimes these torrent sites, for some ungodly reason, always has like porn playing whenever you go to the seed link. Why has every chick got a butt plug in her ass? I don't understand. Like, they're
or
like
a tentacle.
Do we need to fire up the brony porn again?
Oh, God.
No, but I'm sitting there, and it was really awkward the one time, because my dad came over, and he's like, can you download this for me? I'm like, sure. Yeah, sure. And he typically sits where you're sitting, so he can't see the screen. For some ungodly reason that day, he sat where Dan's sitting. And I totally forgot that it does this. So it loads up, and he's watching it. This chick's giving head, and it's just fucking graphic as fuck. And rips off the yoga pants, and goes, what is that? What is that? I'm like, Dad, that's a butt plug.
Conversations you'd rather not have with your dad.
Oh, yeah, there's a sound. Like, my dad once heard me having sex with one of my ex-girlfriends at the time. I knew that could happen, so it was like the super quiet session, if you know what I mean. And they came downstairs, didn't say anything. He just looked at me and went...
He gave you the nod, and that's it. Were you like, you know, going to the washroom, caught you? Like,
well, she didn't understand. She was French, so it's fine. Whatever. She was like,
oh, that one.
She was a Quebecois, you know what I mean? And I'm sitting there, I'm like, and he just looked at me. And I was like, ah, fuck, he knows. I feel unclean, and then I never had sex in my house ever again.
Version of this could just see the look on your face with that nod. I'm like, I approve of that too now. Like, I want to, like, high-five your dad. Like, dude, fucking right.
And literally, after the success of living at home with time, and that's like, I'm never having sex here again, because if that ever happens again, he'll probably be sitting there. It'll be like 3 o'clock in the morning.
He's having a popcorn.
Going downstairs.
He just peeks out of the dark room with a nod. Right, and you're like, oh.
Going downstairs, grab a Gatorade, open the fridge door, shut it. There he is behind the fridge door going. Oh, that would be fucking creepy as fuck.
Fucking dad nods. Oh, the daddy
I
nod
can
of
never,
approval.
I know.
No, this is something we got to you got to put into the vault and remember.
What, the nod?
No. I was just thinking it would be really funny in the new year, because how I am so, I keep all this so separate to my home life, but have a show titled "To the Gen, Do Not Listen to This," just to see what happens and to see how much shit I get.
You know what? It should just be a complete, clean political debate. We'll talk about just social issues.
Every now and then.
Mental health.
Every now and then you throw in a...
Hashtag me too.
Jen, you better turn this off now. And then continue.
Oh my God, that'd be so bad. She still would be mad at you.
Yeah, that would be.
Dad, don't fuck with me.
I know you're spot checking the episode.
When I share it over, I'll be sure to tag her saying, Jen, don't listen to this.
Yeah.
Oh God. Don't listen to this, Jen.
Oh. Challenge.
Challenge accepted.
Oh, that would be great.
So,
there's no mention of that on this episode. Like, on
I don't
anything,
know what you're talking
so,
about.
Exactly.
I'm, talking about. I'm just going to say, do you have a prenup? You might want to get one. Oh, you know, you can start moving all your money to an offshore account somewhere that you can't
Cayman
find.
Cayman Islands.
Yeah.
Make sure you find a country with no extradition.
Every guy has like a hidden stash of money.
I take it all back.
You better start moving
it all
that
back,
money
Dan,
around.
Dan, you have one, don't you?
What's that?
Every man has a hidden stash of money. Yeah. Jen does not know that he has a hidden stash of money because it doesn't exist.
I think she knows that I have the hidden
stash,
but she knows what the hidden stash is
Dan,
for.
Dan, it doesn't exist.
No, why would I do something like that?
No, it doesn't exist.
Because that would be consisting of a lie.
Oh.
He doesn't do that.
Wow, this Christmas episode is going pretty dark.
Don't.
You do know
we can still hear you.
And she knows I have a hidden stash because I use it to buy shit for.
This is
just that tunk as you hit the mic.
The best thing is that tunk
Christmas
is
episode.
My wedding ring hitting the mic.
Oh, it's like you're swearing on the Bible
Merry
or
Christmas,
something like that,
baby.
It's like,
guys, she doesn't know.
Stop talking about it, guys.
She'll never know. My hand's over the microphone. She can't hear me.
There's only three other mics in the room.
By the way, she doesn't know I got her a fucking laptop for Christmas. She'll never know, right?
Right.
Shit. I was going to get her a laptop.
I can't now.
I wasn't.
You know what she wants? Peace and quiet.
There's no fucking chance she's getting that. Like, no way.
Are you going to crack out the Glee album as soon as it's time?
We've been listening to Glee for the last 2 fucking months.
AJ, I think there's something wrong with him. This is Glee.
What's that?
Nothing. Nothing. Me and AJ were having a conversation over the mics.
In September, we pulled out the Glee Christmas just to piss off my kids.
You?
We're very Christmassy.
I get that.
It's
love Christmas.
Fucking September.
Yeah.
You know, people have been pissed
just to
away
piss
for less than
this. Though.
There was a
Keep
guy
in
soccer. It wasn't even a professional game. He missed the goal. They chopped off his fucking leg. Okay? You're celebrating Christmas in December. I mean, September.
People have been shot for less.
We put our tree up way late this year.
Oh, what? So what'd you put up in November?
13th.
Oh,
November.
My gosh. At least you did after Remembrance
way
Day.
Way late. Way late. We're usually the first. Well, they say don't put it up before
Remembrance
Day.
Is your Christmas decorations outside yet?
No, it is. Oh, yeah. They're way up. We got lasers.
Like, do you have a lot? Oh, you have lasers.
Oh, yeah. We got the fucking lasers.
Are you
going to
be like one of those crazy people that have like the music get synced up, like the lights
he's
get synced up?
He's going to do the Trans-Siberian Orchestra Christmas Canon.
No, no. Seek and Destroy Metallica.
If I had the money, I totally would.
Cannibal Corpse, Hammer Smash Face.
They have all kinds of crazy Christmas lights.
See, you have to understand that. No, I'm not going to get into this. This is going to get too political. Never mind.
What the fuck does Christmas lights have to do with being political?
No, the decorations before Remembrance Day.
Well, I think it's only fair because you just celebrated Halloween. You don't even celebrate Halloween, but you just had Halloween.
You just had Halloween.
You should do anything this summer. Excuse me.
The most important day is, of course, Remembrance Day because if it wasn't for the sacrifices they made, we wouldn't be able to put up Christmas decorations early or celebrate Halloween or celebrate Christmas. So,
I don't know about that.
Okay, but by the same token, okay, Valentine's Day is coming up. What are you going to do? You going to like celebrate it like a month before, right after New Year's?
No, we're going to take our Christmas decorations down.
Right.
On Valentine's Day.
I take my Christmas decor down on Boxing Day. It's stroke of midnight, everything comes down.
Are you
going
to celebrate Easter, you know, 2 days after Valentine's Day?
Yeah, you should.
Easter is a holiday.
Oh, wait, fuck you.
It is.
Fuck you. St. Patrick's Day comes first.
Easter is a holiday.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
So St. Patrick's Day is a holiday?
No, Christmas is not a season.
Tis the season to be jolly.
There's 12 days of Christmas. Anything more than that, you can go fuck yourself.
Oh, shit. Shots are getting fired here.
Right?
Scrooge.
Bah humbug.
That's a good movie. One day you will learn the true meaning of Christmas.
Butt plugs?
Butt plugs.
I'm just gonna
and piss balls.
You know, I thought about this now, and I should have brought it up in the last episode. What was my favorite memory of 2018?
Wrong episode. No, it's too late.
Hold on,
you ruined your turn.
I'm gonna tell you.
You ruined your turn.
Piss flaps.
Fuck. Piss flaps. Yes. It's come back.
Okay, that's it. That's all we're gonna say about piss flaps because piss flaps has nothing to do on a Christmas episode.
That's it. He's broken again.
I mean, you shouldn't pop your piece when you're saying piss flaps. P-flaps.
P-flaps, yeah.
You know what? I was actually going to make a shirt that says P-flaps. And it's going to be like an actual P and then flaps.
Yeah.
Like the vegetable P?
Yeah, but people are going to think it's like a marble.
Oh, it won't be
marble
a marble
flap? What's a marble flap?
No, you put it in the pod. You put the P in the pod. You put the P in the pod to do the piss flaps.
A whole pot of peas?
Piss flaps.
So.
This shit is full.
Boom, 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 boom. Oh, I'm going to put that on now.
What?
Nothing. Continue.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Where were we?
I don't know.
You're talking about Christmas and piss flaps.
But we were arguing about the Christmas, you know,
and you were saying Easter is a holiday, Christmas is a season.
Yes.
No, it's a holiday.
Season.
It's a holiday.
Season.
No. Winter is a season.
No, but there's the Christmas season.
Yeah, which is 12 days.
Yes, in America, it typically starts from U.S. Thanksgiving between then and New Year's Eve.
Okay, so since that...
The holiday season.
Okay, so that's November, the end of November, last Thursday in November.
Oh. Yes.
And why are you now doing it like almost a month earlier than that?
Because it's such a joyous time, why not?
An asshole in his bathrobe.
So why don't you celebrate Christmas starting in, say, June?
Hold up a second. There we go.
Yeah. You checked our shitters, honey?
You checked our shitters, honey?
It's illegal.
The fact is, there's so many people who have not seen this movie.
It's not truly Christmas till you see this movie.
That's not true. Die Hard.
Die Hard.
Yeah, Die Hard's up there, but okay. Taking Die Hard out of the equation. So, taking Die Hard.
Tiddly bit nipply, hopes get lahoos.
Taking Die Hard, the greatest Christmas movie ever made, out of the equation. What would be the second
Christmas story?
Christmas story?
Bullshit.
Red Baby Gun?
Fuck you.
I didn't like Christmas Story.
Yeah, but you know.
You didn't?
Nope.
It's great.
Scrooged.
No.
Murray.
I Scrooged.
Christmas Story. You shoot your eye out, kid. And part of it was also filmed in the area.
Jingle All the Way.
Pass.
Is that the one with Sinbad?
No, Schwarzenegger.
Schwarzenegger with a freaking toy.
What was the one with Sinbad?
Sinbad made a movie?
Christmas movie, yeah.
I don't know.
He was in Jingle All the Way with Schwarzenegger, I think.
I don't know, but...
I think he was.
It could have been.
I don't know.
You know it's good because he only has one name.
My Google Mini's in the other room, so I can't ask. I can't figure it out.
Okay, Google. There you go. What was the Christmas movie with Sinbad?
Didn't work.
Oh, it's like...
Booyah! Thank you, Google.
All the way. That's pretty bad that it yelled it from my bedroom.
But from your bat cave? Were you going to call it the bat cave?
Well, some things get slayed in that cave.
Merry Christmas from the bat cave.
Okay. Thank you, Google. I love the fucking thing, man. It's amazing. I've been fucking toying with it all day. I've been having conversations with it. You heard me talking to it earlier.
Google is obsessed with Todd. Google fucking loves Todd. Seriously.
Hold on, take your headphones off. Okay, Google. Do you like me?
You're my favorite person ever.
Ever.
Okay, Google.
Will the mics pick that up?
Do you like AJ? Oh, man, you just got friend-zoned by fucking the internet.
Fuck you, AJ. Google. From Google.
Eat a dick.
Okay, Google.
Eat a dick.
Google. Okay, Google.
You know, the microphones can't hear Google in the other room.
Okay, Google. Do you eat dicks?
I don't understand.
Yeah, Google's dumb.
Okay, Google. Okay, Google. Do you like Dan?
I'd tell you if I knew.
Ooh, yeah, fucking friend zone. Okay, Google. Would you friend zone me?
Let's be friends forever.
Ah, fuck, I got friend zoned.
You did.
Okay, Google.
Stop leaving her alone.
Is Dan the bestest ever?
Sorry, I'm not sure how to help
it. Leave her alone, okay? This is my girl.
You're confusing her.
No, I wanted... I should have grabbed Alexa. Alexa's the one that gets really fucking sassy with you.
Oh, can you change Google's name?
I don't think so.
You can change, like, the voice.
So, Christmas is upon us. We're enjoying it, obviously, being a bunch of fucking morons.
Yes.
Jen, don't listen to this episode.
No, that's later.
That's New Year's. That's
I know what he got episode. You for Christmas. Would you like to know?
I haven't even told you.
Oh, he did.
No, I didn't.
He got it from a specialty store.
What am I going to
leave it at that?
He did it when he did one of these.
No, legit, I am getting her something from the specialty store. Because
he just got the nod from both me and AJ.
No, because this episode is being aired on Christmas Eve. We are already back from our Disney trip.
Do you think he's
specialty
going
tour? Store downtown Disney.
Is he gonna? Oh, I thought he was gonna say. Is he gonna do the deal?
He's done the deal.
What's no one ever kicks deal? Out of Falcon Arrow.
I give her a Falcon Arrow. That'd be fucking so funny.
And you would be so divorced.
Do it in the bedroom in the hotel.
I had a friend who.
This way you don't hurt her.
I had a friend who was fooling around with his girlfriend. He gave her a power bomb, and her head hit the ceiling. Another time, he gave
her. What kind of people you're hanging out with?
And then
us.
And then another friend gave his girlfriend as a joke to pick her up into her German suplex. Yeah, they went through the chair. Both of them. He's like, German! And I'm like, this is a bad idea. It's one of those stupid IKEA chairs, but there's no legs to it. It bends like this. Went right to the damn chair. I popped for it. I thought it was fucking hilarious. Take her down to the Kimura Lock. Olympic Slam! Down on the mat! Anyways.
And a heartache. What?
That's love. German.
So... our Christmas episode's coming to an end already. We're just burning through all these episodes right now.
Yeah. Right. Well, this episode is live on Christmas Eve.
Oh, yeah, because we record everything live, never in advance.
Never. Right.
You know, I don't even know how many interviews have been up at this point.
Lots.
Like a
gajillion?
Well, we've talked to a lot of people this year.
We sure have.
Yeah. AJ's talked to no one.
I don't think I had any interviews this year.
You didn't interview
me. The last one I remember was the ToyCon and Jim and the Holograms.
You interviewed her?
With Dan, yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't listen to that one. Is that bad?
No. She was great. She was great.
Yeah,
she was awesome.
Talking
about music and shit.
I guess you would say she's a gem.
Oh.
So we're going to finish up this episode and take...
Get off the stairs. Three more funny.
We're going to take Dan down to the specialty store in Niagara Falls. We're going to give you a Kickstarter of what you should get for Christmas.
Well, okay.
It's okay. She won't know.
Fake vagina.
Sorry. And whatever you...
Just like the tunk from the wedding ring. Great.
And whatever you do, I'm like, Dan, don't look up blueberry waffle, Jen. Don't look up blueberry waffle, Jen.
No.
He's already scarred. Oh. The scars are reopening.
All right, AJ, got nothing left to say for Christmas.
Merry fucking ho-ho.
Ooh. All right, Dan.
As he yawns.
Because he's worried about getting in way too much trouble after this episode airs.
Yes. okay. Sorry, Jen. Bye-bye. When I'll ride with your Christmas of white, but I have a blue.